Well, she says the allegations come as a surprise to the department, and by all accounts from those who work directly with this driver, he's a good employee. But tonight, he's been removed of his responsibilities behind the wheel.
Current status of this employee, he's currently is not driving.
That's because of the investigation launched after this Taking Action For You story we brought you last night.
It was only brought to my attention through Channel 7 story yesterday.
It's a story of a Detroit DOT driver allegedly making videos while behind the wheel of a city bus. We are not showing you his face because he has not been charged with a crime, but his actions could result in his firing.
The policy is zero telephone usage as far as talking on the phone. They cannot be behind the seat talking on a cell phone. It's against transit regulations. This behavior is not representative of the department. DDOT has upward of 500 drivers. This incident was surprising to all of us.
We asked DDOT Director Angelica Jones of any past incidents on the driver's record.
Well, since we're on an investigation, I cannot state in regards to what he has on his record. But far as I have been sharing with my leadership of the operations division, they have told me this is a great driver. He hasn't had many incidents at all.
We also asked Jones about the department's background check after a Secretary of State record check on his driving history showed citations in 2006 of open intoxicants and 2007 of disobeying a traffic signal.
Those may be beyond the statutory limits for us of hiring him. He was hired in 2017, so therefore those incidences may not apply to him being employed.
Regardless, these multiple videos, 18 in total, are now under review. The driver not on leave, but his responsibilities no longer include driving.
Trying to figure out he was actually stationary. So those are some of the things that we're looking to investigate to ensure that any rules and regulations for us have not been broken.
So Brian Abel back out live for us now. And Brian, do we know how long this investigation could last?
We do. Director Jones tells us that this investigation could take anywhere between 15 to 30 days. Glenda?